So median filtering for background subtraction does exactly what you might think. All right. Now we're going to assume that the background will be modeled by the last n frames, but I'm not going to take the average. I'm going to take the median value. What's kind of nice about that is now n can be kind of nice and long. Let's suppose the average, let's suppose when I look at the road, let's suppose its value is 57, plus or minus a little, 57, 58, 56, 52, 57, et cetera. Then comes along a white car, and it's like got 112, 119, 194, fine. Then comes along a black Porsche, slowly, because he's being cool. You know, it's 3 and 9. But if you take a look at all those values, the one that's going to dominate is going to be the 57, the 56, et cetera. So when I do a median filter, that's the one that's going to get pulled out. So now your foreground mask is we just take the current image and we subtract out the median of the last n frames. Okay, and again, threshold. Your n, by the way, now is a little less sensitive. I mean, it has to be big enough to capture it. There is, as you know, those of you know about computing, a running average is easy to compute. You just have to know how many frames you've added into the average so far and the previous average, and then it's 1 over n of the new one plus n minus 1 over n of the old one. A median, you actually have to keep them and then resort them, and that can be expensive. So unless you play some interesting tricks, median filtering can be expensive, but it's not too much of a problem. All right, when you apply the median, well, it turns out if you use a short n, it might not be quite so great. So, for example, here we have the estimated background, and you can see a lot of stuff has gotten cleaned up, but because of the small n, I still get this problem in terms of where the van is. And you're doing a better job getting the van, but you still get a little bit of this stuff.